In this video, we're going to look at the East Bay Real Estate Market Report for November 2021. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is Mac Rogers. I'm a real estate broker here in the East Bay. So let's start off with a summary. This is for all types of properties, condos, townhomes, and single family detached homes. Let's start off with Alameda County. For Alameda County, the number of sales is up 2.33%. In October of 2020, we had 1,372 sales. In October of 2021, we had 1,404. New listings are down almost 14%, 13.65% to be exact. Back in October of 2020, we had 1,729 new listings. This past October, we had 1,493. The average days on the market is down, or properties are selling faster. In October of 2020, average days on the market was 22 days. In October of 2021, down to 19 days. The median selling price for Alameda County is up almost 20%, 19.56, from 907,500 to 1,085,000. The median list price also up almost 14%, from 849,999 to 966,500. Now let's look at Contra Costa County. The number of sales down almost 9%, 8.52%. In October of 2020, 1,444. This past October, 1,321. New listings down 18%. October of 2020, 1,783. October 2021, 1,459. The average days on the market, roughly the same, from 21 days down to 20 days. The median sales price is up 13%, from 725,000 to 820,000. The median list price is also up. It's up 14.51%, from 689,000 to 789,000. So that's the summary overview for Alameda and Contra Costa County. Now, let's check out the regional data. Okay, let's start with the 880 corridor and let's look at the number of homes for sale. The number of homes for sale, Alameda down a big 19%. Albany, no change. Berkeley, Castro Valley, Fremont, all down. Hayward, up 9%. Newark, down a big 38%. Oakland, also down. San Leandro, down. San Lorenzo was up. Union City, also down 25%. Sales prices in the 880 corridor, all up. Take a look at these numbers. Alameda, up 7%. Albany, up 13%. Berkeley, up 16% to 1.7 million. Castro Valley, up a big 32%, 1,285,000. Newark, up a big 45%, 1,388,000. And like I said, all of the rest of the cities also all up. The number of homes sold, a bit mixed. Alameda up 32%. Albany down 13%. Newark down a big 21%. San Lorenzo up a big 42%. Now let's move on to West Contra Costa County and look at the number of homes for sale. El Cerrito up a big 333%. From 6 properties back in October of 2020 to 26 this past October. El Sobrani, Hercules both down. Pinole up 60%, Richmond down, and San Pablo up. Sales prices in West Contra Costa County a little bit less expensive than the 880 corridor. They're all up as well. El Cerrito up 10%, El Sobrani up 18%, Hercules up 33% from 680,000 to 901,000. Pinole up 7%, Richmond up 5%, and San Pablo up 21%. The number of homes sold in West Contra Costa County a bit mixed. El Cerrito down. El Sobrani up 36%. Hercules also down. Pinole, no change. Richmond down 21%. And San Pablo up a big 79% from 14 properties to 25 properties. Let's move on to Central Contra Costa County and look at homes for sale. Clayton down 44%. Concord up 12%. Martinez up 8%. Pleasant Hill down 65%, and Walnut Creek down 39%. Central Contra Costa County sales prices are all up across the board as well. Clayton up 17% from 920,000 to 1,075,000. Concord up 14%. Martinez also up 17%. Pleasant Hill up 6%. Walnut Creek up 10%. The number of homes sold in Central Contra Costa County a bit mixed. Clayton down 40%. Concord down 11%. Martinez up 9%. Pleasant Hill up 34%. And Walnut Creek down 18%. Now let's move on to La Mirinda. The number of homes for sale all down. Lafayette down 57%. Moraga down 73%. Orinda down 72%. Sales prices, yep, you got it, all up in La Mirinda. Lafayette up 11%. Moraga up 4%. Orinda up 1%. And then the number of homes for sale, Lafayette and Moraga both down, with Orinda the only one that's up. Now let's move on to the Tri-Valley and look at the number of homes for sale. The number of homes for sale, only Livermore was up. Livermore up 13%. Alamo down 40%. Danville down 59%. Dublin down 93%. Pleasanton down 62%. And San Ramon down 64%. Tri-Valley home prices are all up except for Alamo. Alamo down 9% from $2,644,000 to a bargain basement price of $2,400,000. Danville up 23%. Dublin up 27%, Livermore up 21%, Pleasanton up 32%, and San Ramon up 34%. The number of homes sold in the Tri-Valley, again, also only Livermore was up. Livermore up 18%, Alamo down 27%, Danville down 20%, Dublin down 13%, Pleasanton down 9%, and San Ramon down 5%. And finally, let's move on to the Delta. The Delta home, number of homes for sale also mixed. Antioch up 35%. Brentwood down 32%. Discovery Bay down 6%. Oakley up 19%. Pittsburgh up 38%. Home prices in the Delta are all also up. Antioch up 14%. Brentwood up 22%. Discovery Bay up 32%. Oakley up 19%. In Pittsburgh, up 17%. The number of homes sold on the Delta, only Antioch and Pittsburgh were up. Antioch up 21%, Pittsburgh up 6%. Brentwood down 12%, Discovery Bay down 33%, and Oakley down 18%. So that's the East Bay Real Estate Market Report. Thanks for viewing, and I hope you have a great day.